Hey, assuming you're actually a Lightroom subscriber and you use Lightroom to post-process your images, one of the most common questions people have is, how do I copy images into Lightroom? So let's basically clear the air around this feature here. By the way, can I please request you to subscribe to this channel so that you get all the updates that we send? Also, it's a good idea to hit the bell icon so that you get instant notifications when we have new content. So, theoretically, you don't copy anything into Lightroom. So what happens is you're copying your files from your camera, rather which is sitting in your memory card, through Lightroom. It's not into Lightroom, but it's through Lightroom, which means you're actually not copying into Lightroom. You're copying it through Lightroom, but the destination could be something else, which is probably your desktop or your MacBook Pro or your notepad or whatever else, or your external hard disk for that matter. So let's take a use case. You shot pictures in Africa today and you have a 64 GB card full of images. Now you don't copy these images into Lightroom. You basically need to copy these images into your external hard disk, but you actually do it while you open Lightroom, which means you do it through Lightroom. You attach your memory card on one end of your laptop through a USB a port, and you open Lightroom, and the other end of your laptop, you should probably be having your external hard disk unless you want to download the pictures to your desktop. And if you look at the Lightroom's interface, and let's go ahead and click on the import feature of Lightroom, in which you'll actually see there is a source, there's actually a destination. Now, in case we want to copy, let's select copy here, and when you're wanting to copy, you're supposed to go ahead and select a source. In my case, let's say I have a source here called a tiger sample. I have four pictures that, let's assume, is sitting in my memory card. I'm supposed to go ahead and browse my memory card here to select the source of these files that I want to copy. Once I copy, or rather the select the source here, and I'm telling Lightroom, please copy these four files, and I go ahead and select copy here. Please note, I'm not selecting move or I'm not selecting add. I'm actually selecting copy here, and then it allows me to enable my destination folder. I go ahead and say where the destination should be. Let's say the destination should be something else that I select. In my case, let's select yet another folder here called destination in my desktop, just for us to see how the files from the source, which was called as Tiger Sample, is now moved to my destination. So my source is on the desktop, it's called Tiger Sample, and my destination on the desktop is called destination, just for us to understand how things are done here. While importing, I'll also go ahead and say I don't want to organize it by date. I just want to import all of these together so that I can see quickly how I'm using Lightroom's interface to copy files from point A. In your example, it could be a memory card. In this example, it's on my desktop in a folder, which should actually end up in my destination folder. Exactly when I go and press import, those four files are being copied, and ideally, it should be in both places. When you go to your desktop, you go ahead and see in the Tiger sample, there are four files. You go back and you open the destination, you have the four files sitting here. So traditionally, Lightroom is not used to actually copy files into, but it is used to copy files through it to some other destination. Well, this is a very interesting way of actually image management. And if you want to learn more about how you can use Lightroom's library module, you should actually be buying the Lightroom course, which talks about the Lightroom classic CC version. And we go deeper and deeper into image management, also develop module there. And if you want to receive videos like these for free, you should subscribe to the Toehold TV. Click on the bell icon below in this video to subscribe to it. By the way, if you want to buy the Lightroom course, we also have a link in the description, and you can actually be learning Lightroom in a greater detail.